for the serious gamer.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is day three of my health and fitness video series, and this is day three of our four-day split. And today we're doing legs. Oh boy! So we're gonna be doing some heavy lifting here. This is the old squat rack. My friend and I welded it together. I went and picked up some steel at the local steel supermarket. Yes, and got everything pre-cut. And we welded it together, mostly in the garage, and then to finish the assembly, did it down here in the basement. I got it attached to some rafters up here, and that's about it. So it seems to be doing okay. I actually have this, you can actually see it here, these bars that come across, and there's actually these angled bars here. I've got some more down here, so I can actually like do shrugs or barbell curls if I wanted to. And obviously this is going to help, just in case I drop the weight, or I can't lift it up or do another squat, I can drop it down onto here and duck out of the way. So you definitely need something like that when you're doing squats by yourself, even with somebody else, because oftentimes they're not going to be able to hold the weight if you were to not be able to get it up. Hey, one other thing, I'm going to run a little poll on this video, so I'm going to make three comments in the poll, and I'm going to base my decision on which one gets the most thumbs up. So, it's about this thing, alright? Actually, I was looking for the trimmers yesterday, and I couldn't find them, so I didn't get to trim it. But, what do you guys want me to do? Either A, just get rid of it. It's like spider bite. Get that freaking thing off your face. B, keep it trim. Or C, just keep growing it out or do something drastic with it. I don't know. Thumbs up, and if you have any comments about it, leave a comment, and that's it. So, I'm actually going to drop the weight a little bit. I'm going to start off with just one plate, just as a warm-up. And one other thing that I should mention is that you guys should be doing, you know, I'm not trying to come across as a professional trainer or anything, I'm just showing you what I do. But, I mean, you want to properly warm up. Like, I wouldn't say jump into what I'm doing here. Like, I've been back pretty solid for the last 3 months doing this, so obviously you want to start off with lower weights, get used to it. I mean, get used to the muscle soreness you're going to have afterwards, or the next day or two after you do a workout, and then gradually increase your weight. So after, you know, 6 or 8 weeks, maybe then you want to start pushing it like I have been doing in the last two videos, and hopefully in these two videos. Also, you know, proper form, and I know I don't have the best form. I mean, I try, and I wouldn't say it's horrible. Maybe those dumbbell flies I did on day one are kind of horrible, but other than that, and you gotta take into consideration the Bowflex. I mean, it's not the best for maintaining form. Like, I am coming down a little too far, like on my bench press, the flat bench. You know, yeah, I am coming down too far, but that's just, I don't know, it just has to do with, you know, more of the Bowflex than anything. So that's about it. I'm going to drop the weight, and I'll be back, and we'll do our warm-up set. Okay, so I dropped the weight. I do wear a weight belt, and there are arguments for and against wearing these things, but I don't think it really hurts you. It may actually help your back a little bit, depending, I mean, especially if you're at the tail end of a heavy set, and you're trying to finish off the last couple of reps, and you may not have exactly proper form. I think it does help, but again, it's open to interpretation, but I mean, I wear it. So for squats, you can either do usually your stance, and we're going to get a sort of a rear side view. I'll try and get a side view, but I don't have a lot of room here. I try and keep my feet about shoulder width apart and the toes pointed out slightly, okay? And when you come down, like, I try and keep my head up, so I'm gonna be standing like this. I try and keep my head up and my back arched a little bit, and then come down. And there are probably guys here out there that'll argue, I mean, I don't go low enough in my squat, but I find that if I go lower than I do, that I'm working more my ass, which I don't really want to, and I strain my knees a lot more. So it's just what I find. Maybe I'm going with too high weight, but again, I just think that the strain, you want to work, you know, your leg here, And I think when you go a lot lower than what I do, you're working more, like I said, your ass, which I don't really want to. I mean, why drop the weight so I can work my ass off? Wait a second. My ass is big enough. I don't need it any bigger, all right? Anyways. Sorry. All right, let's do the first, or the warm-up set anyway. One other thing I'm trying to improve upon is that when you're doing any exercise, especially when you're going heavy, you want to inhale, sort of, let's say for instance you're doing a bench press, okay? You want to inhale as you're coming down with the bar, and as you're exerting the force to push it back up, you want to exhale during the time that you're pushing it up, alright? I'm going to try to do that here. One other thing. Also, and this goes with cardio, I went out and bought a recumbent bike the other day. And, oh man, I'm such a nerd. I can actually, like, I got it set up in front of my TV so I can ride my bike and play at the same time. I know I gotta get out more, but hey, I get out. I do lots of other things outside. Anyways, it's actually kind of fun. I've only had an opportunity to do it once, because I just got it the other day. I'm going to try and start 3 days a week for about half an hour, do that for a few weeks, and then build up to an hour and more resistance and higher intensity. So I'm going to throw some more weight on, and we'll be back. Okay, guys, we're back for our first heavy set. I got 295 on the bar here. And one thing you will notice that when we did weld this together, that these are a bit high, so I had to add some mats here, but I took one away to use for the recumbent bike, so it's going to be a little awkward getting the weight back on. It shouldn't be too much of a problem getting it off. It's getting it back on, so I might lift either side just to do that. Anyways, and what I'll try to do is on the next set is get a side view if I can, all right? Thank you.
Okay. Thing is with the squats, there's no way in hell I'm gonna go to failure. I'll try and get close, but I don't want to have to drop it down on here to get it off my shoulders. So I will not go to failure with squats. Alright, I'll try and change the camera up and we'll come back for a second set. Alright, we got the camera moved, guys. Before I do the next set, one thing I want to touch on was nutrition, and I'm not going to do like a separate video for it. Like, I'll do updates maybe like on a weekly basis or more if you guys really want. But probably just like once a week for a little while, or once every 2 weeks, I don't know. But nutrition-wise, like, I've cut out, not that I had a lot of sugar intake, I cut it out completely, except I've kept my coffee in the morning, but I've cut back the sugar by about half in my coffee. So I'll have one or two cups in the morning, but that's about it. I need some ideas for some breakfast foods, though, because I don't really like yogurt. I can't eat bran. You know, I have toast, I guess, but that's not the greatest thing to have. I got oatmeal, but regular oatmeal without anything in it is kind of disgusting. It's like paste. So I don't like grapefruit. So I'm not exactly sure. I'm kind of at a loss. Maybe you guys can help me out with some breakfast foods. But, you know, for snacks and lunch, I usually have some fruit, bananas. Lunch, I'll have a salad. Depends on what I have. Like, if I have a bigger lunch, then I'll skip the salad. But if I, you know, if I can have something smaller with a salad, then I'll do that. And same with dinner. And then a couple snacks in between. I still do take some protein powder, but mostly at night, just on workout days. But I may cut that out entirely once I'm done my current container of protein powder. Other than that, I used to take a supplement before, like a half an hour before I worked out, sort of like a, you know, some of you have mentioned taking caffeine beforehand. Not too keen on that, but I was taking, I don't remember what it's called. There's one that I used to take, it was called Rich Gaspari Super Pump 2000, something like that. But I ran out the other day, so I don't know if I'm going to buy it again or not. I'm not sure. I might go without it for a while and just see how things go. Because I don't really think you need that kind of stuff. I don't know. Anyways, let's do our last set here for squats. I should get a lower view. Maybe I'll move the camera down a little bit. Okay? There, I put it down that far so you can sort of get a better view of the stance. And then you'll see sort of my leg, or my entire leg, as I perform the squat. Hopefully this turns out all right. All right, here we go. Okay. Alright, I'll move the camera back up. Alright, I really don't know what that's going to look like until I see it later when I'm editing. Who knows if I'll keep it. I guess we'll see. Okay, so that's it for squats. I mean, I didn't go really that close to failure that time. I don't know why. It's kind of hard to push squats. To push it too far. Oh well, at any rate, we'll pick it up on the next few exercises. So we're going to do next thing we're going to do are leg extensions, which are not the greatest to do on the Bowflex, but we're, you know, for leg workout, we're kind of limited. And then we'll do leg curls, and then we'll do some stuff for our calves, and that'll be it. So I'll be back with the leg extensions in a few minutes. All right, you're not going to get to see my face when I do this, but we're going to do some leg extensions. Like I said, they're not the best on the Bowflex, but not much I can do. They're not very smooth, and they tend to be a little bit hard on the knees. So one other thing I should mention, and kudos to Bowflex for this, but I called them up about that broken power rod. If you didn't see that, it's near the beginning of day two workout, where I busted one of the 50-pound power rods. I just called them up because I had ordered that. It's like an addition. It's a 100-pound addition to the Bowflex. So I called them up. They had my name on record. I said one of them snapped. I said, okay, we're shipping you out a new power rod. Easy as that. And that's it. So I should get one. It's going to take probably 5 to 10 business days. And I initiated the call about 2 days ago. So, all right, here we go. Oh yeah, I hear those knees snap. That's not good. Or crack. And you can't... I don't know. Whoa. That's coming down. Right back up there. Sorry. Just the way the Bowflex is, you can't, like, fully extend. Otherwise, I would. Okay, that's all I'm going to do. Like I said, even with this exercise, I don't want to push it too hard. Just because the force on the knees. Yeah, I don't know what else to say. So we'll do our second set in a minute. Okay guys, we're back for set two. And we'll try and squeeze these out. We'll try and go to failure on this. I find it more difficult. The most difficult body part to go to failure on is your legs. I don't know. Don't ask me why. It's just the way it is, I guess, for me anyway. All right, here we go. Okay. Woo! All right. That's it for extensions. Alright, that's it for extensions, guys. We're going to do leg curls next. And you're going to get a nice butt shot coming up. Yeah. Okay, guys, you ready for the butt shot? Yeah, here it comes. Let's do some leg curls. Alright. Set and then calves are kind of hard, but for legs, in order to do like a really good leg workout, you really need to go to a gym. I think, I mean, for as far as weightlifting, you know, I could do squats. These aren't the best leg extensions, these aren't the best leg curls either. Leg press, I don't get to do leg press, there's hack squat. I mean, leg press is a big one, and I can do kind of simulated leg presses on this thing, but even with the full weight, with the extra dual 50s, which I broke one, it's not enough weight. I mean, to do a proper, you know, 10 to 12 rep to failure, no, I can't do it. Like, I can do 40 or 50 sort of leg simulated leg presses on the Bowflex before I go to failure. So, it's kind of pointless for what I'm trying to do. Anyways, we'll be back with our second set soon. Okay, we're going to do our second set here, right? I'm sorry about the butt shot. I can't help it. I know you guys like it. Yeah! Oh, yeah, there we go. There we go. All right. Squeeze it out. Couldn't do very many that time. I find you gotta rest a bit longer in between sets when you do legs. Okay, I'm gonna show you what I do for calves, but again, because I lost 100 pounds on the Bowflex, it's not gonna be great, but even then, it's pretty tough because, I mean, your calves in general, or at least mine, can handle a lot of weight, especially if you're doing, you know, if you have weight on your shoulders and you're sort of doing calf raises, you can actually push up quite a bit of weight. So, we basically end up going failure, like 40, 50 reps, something like that. So maybe I'll try and move the camera and we'll do that. Okay, guys, we're going to do some sort of, I don't know what you call them, calf extensions or whatever. So I've got this sliding seat on the Bowflex, and I've got this strap which is attached to the weights to get the full weight on. And this is pretty much the same thing I do to do like a leg press. So for a leg press, I'd just do this, but I would have the belt, see how there's rings on the belt here. I'd have this attached up here, so when I'm coming in here, because right here there's hardly any weight on here on the Bowflex, but if it was attached to these rings, then I'd have full weight, and then when I extend, you know, I'd have basically full resistance on the leg press. But even then, it's not enough weight. So as it is, for the calf extensions, we're just gonna do this and extend the calves. And like I said, I mean, without the extra 100 pounds, it's just ridiculous. I do have another sort of contraption. I made this wooden block, sort of a raised block, and it has 2 feet on it, where I can be holding a couple of dumbbells, and then I sort of lean with my head against the wall, and then do calf raises on that wooden block. Maybe I'll show that just in a future update video. But I don't know. It's almost kind of pointless to do this. I mean, it works some, but yeehaw. Hey, just so you guys know, and should talk about, gotta get some gaming into these workouts, you know what I mean? Medal of Honor just announced that in their multiplayer that you can no longer play as a Taliban. So, you know how in various games you play as Allied forces or Russia or Germany, whatever. So, you know, I'm not exactly sure if it's Allied versus, or if it was Allied versus Taliban or whatever. But now it's Allied versus opposing forces. I don't know. Like, if it turns out that GameStop lifts their ban for selling Medal of Honor in military bases, that's some goddamn marketing genius by Electronic Arts. Because they just got a whole shitload of free publicity based on people freaking out and crying and ranting and raving over the Taliban and how you can play as the Taliban to kill enemy or allied forces. And then they go and change that. And I haven't heard, I'm not confirming that GameStop has lifted the ban, but if they do, I mean, even if they don't, it's a freaking, it was, like, even bad publicity is good publicity. You know what I mean? And, I don't know. I think that game will sell well. It's shaping up to be a good campaign, to have a good campaign to it. And I think Guns did a video about the campaign. And we'll see. We'll see. I mean, I wasn't that impressed with the beta, but hopefully they've managed to improve things drastically. So let's hope that they do. At any rate, I mean, I can't go to failure on these. It's just, I mean, I'll do another set. I'm not going to show it. Whatever. I'm going to do another one anyway. But anyways, so that's it. We'll be doing one more day 4, and then we're just going to have updates for you guys, all right? And see how I'm keeping on track. See if you guys are keeping on track. I know a lot of you guys have stated that you guys are trying to get be more in shape. Maybe I've inspired some of you guys. If I have, if I've even inspired one or two of you guys, that's fantastic. And I mean, this has been well worth it. So one more day, we'll do shoulders, and that'll be it. All right, for Spiderbite, NextGenTactics.com, health and fitness for the serious gamer. That's right. I'm out.